first off, for business, I'm going to ask you to silence your phone so you don't become a part of the performance, as Dr. Yekel often said. Speaking of Dr. Yekel, we hope you enjoy tonight's performance, which is a collection of solos. Dr. Yekel has worked with and trained our students with, and then also the choir pieces that are under the direction of Dr. Dougherty, including the world premiere of Phoenix Cantata. So we're going to get started, and our first solo tonight is music theater major Logan Hurdle.
Thank you. Thank you all for being here tonight. I hope you enjoyed the beginning of that concert with all those wonderful solos, a couple songs for the concert choir. We will now proceed to get ready for the Phoenix Cantata, which is what you're all here to see. So I'll invite the Oratorio first to come on up, and you guys can go to your new spots. And while they're doing that, I'll talk to you a little bit. First, a big thank you to the First Baptist Church here, and Brittany, with the, assistant or associate pastor or something like that. Sorry if I got the name wrong. But we love Brittany, and she's great to work with here. We just love this space for this concert, so thank you for that. Quick shout out to Emily, one of our students back there. She's like on the spot. No. Okay. Emily is running the slides that you'll see for our presentation here in just a minute, so thank you for that. Of course, a big thank you to our students who performed those solos. How about another hand for those? Debt to their wonderful instructor, Dr. Amy Yekel, who sang for you tonight. Thank you, Amy. And of course, a big thank you to Marilyn, who's accompanying all of this tonight. Thank you so much. And of course, last not but least, big thank you to the Oratorio Chorus and to the Concert Choir. For honestly, these many years of being able to work with them and making great music with them, so thank you for having me. On the back of your program, you see upcoming events. I do have one more concert that I'll be able to conduct, and that is the April 26th. So check out the program for details for that if you would like to come support us in our end of year concert. There. And now, on to the Phoenix Cantata. First, at the beginning of movement three, which is called despondency, the audience gets to participate in creating the sonic experience by creating wind sounds with your hands. We're going to practice that right now. So first of all, everyone take your hands and rub them vigorously. So, what's going to happen is at some point, well, you'll be able to follow along the text of your program, but at the end of movement two, I will simply turn like this, and when I am facing you, you start rubbing your hands. We're going to practice, okay? Here we go. You guys are going to start rubbing your hands, ready? Good. That's right. Nice and vigorous. Don't start rubbing your hands until I get to you. We're creating the wind, okay? Wind gets louder and louder. Wonderful. Now, your job is you're going to keep that wind sound going throughout the whole movement three while we sing that movement, okay? You just keep it going. I will tell you, but not because this is a world premiere, so I've never done this one, but other songs that have this type of thing, typically people get going and then they just kind of forget and they stop. So I mean, just be aware of that and try to keep it going for our sake so we can have that wind sound throughout the movement. By the end of the movement, you will know when it's over because the choir will be making rain sounds, like this, okay? And when that starts to die down, you'll see my hands going down like this, the rain sounds die down, and that's when your wind will die down as well. It'll be pretty obvious, okay? And then we move right on to the next movement, all right? So that's movement three, be ready for that, and you get to participate. Little preparatory message I'm gonna read for you. So, Phoenix Cantata takes place in a flower garden. The movements move in a succession from themes of pride and joy, followed by hardship from the storms of life, the despair that one can often that can often follow, and the confusion about the direction one should take in life. This is followed by a parable of the barriers that come from mistaking offers of help for suppression, and we end with an understanding of love, growth, and acceptance. I would like to read for you the beginning of the program notes. It says, drawing inspiration from the mythical symbolism of the phoenix, this cantata narrates the journey through life's challenges and tribulations and explores how we can learn to comprehend, embrace, and grow from them. Although not explicitly mentioned. The underlying message resonates with the tale of the phoenix, which is, after facing adversity or transformation, we emerge stronger and more beautiful. Each of the six movements centers on a flower garden, the gardener's affection for the garden, the looming storm that could devastate it, and the gardener's eventual realization that, even after the storm, the garden remains beautiful and precious. I encourage you to read the rest of the program note on your own, perhaps even as we perform, in order to better understand each movement's purpose. Doing so will greatly increase your overall experience with tonight's performance. Also, during the performance, you will see a slideshow that tells the story as we sing. I also encourage you to follow along your program with the text of each movement as we sing, which will allow for maximum understanding and immersion to the deep emotions evoked by what you will hear. And finally, we ask that you please hold your applause until the end of the final movement. Without further ado, we present Phoenix Cantata.